We defined arc length using an integral.
The integral that we'll be using is this one. I'm going to be integrating from a to b the square root of 1 plus the derivative squared dx.
Let's apply this to a specific problem. Let's compute the arc length of a little piece of a graph.
So let's look at the graph of y squared equals x cubed and figure out the length of this arc from 0, 0 to 1, 1. Now I could rewrite this equation. Instead of writing y squared equals x cubed, I could write y equals x to the 3 halves power.
We'll start by differentiating.
So because of this, I can write dy dx is 3 halves x to the 1 half power.
We'll put that derivative into the formula for arc length.
So I'm going to be integrating x goes from 0 to 1, the square root of 1 plus this derivative squared, so I'll write 3 halves x to the 1 half squared dx.
Now I just want to compute that integral, but how?
Well, I can rewrite the integrand. This is the integral from 0 to 1 of the square root of 1 plus 3 halves squared is 9 fourths, and x to the 1 half squared, all at x, dx.
Just have no fear. Keep going.
Well, I could use substitution. U equals 1 plus 9 fourths x, so that du is 9 fourths x, or alternatively, dx is 4 ninths du. And that means this integral is the same as the integral of square root of u times 4 ninths du. And what are my new bounds of integration? Well, when x is 0, u is 1. And when x is 1, u is 13 fourths. All right. Now I just have to write down an antiderivative here. Well, I could write this as 4 ninths u to the 3 halves over 3 halves. That's an antiderivative for square root u, evaluated at 1 and 13 fourths. So then I just got to plug in 13 fourths, plug in 1, take the difference. Okay, so this is 4 ninths. I'll write times 2 thirds instead of dividing by 3 halves, times 13 fourths to the 3 halves power minus 4 ninths times 2 thirds times 1 to the 3 halves power. I could simplify this a little bit more even. Let's see here. 4 times 2 is 8, but that's also 4 to the 3 halves power. So I can cancel all of these things. And then I can simplify, do some arithmetic here. So I've got, 13 to the 3 halves power divided by 9 times 3 is 27 minus, this is 8 27ths, just times 1. And if you don't like the 3 halves here, I could write this as 13 times the square root of 13 over 27 minus 8 over 27. This is the length of that arc.
We did it, but it worked out almost too well, right? That's the sad thing about arc length calculations. Because the arc length formula involves that square root of 1 plus a derivative squared, it's extraordinarily unlikely that if you just give me some random function, I'm going to succeed in being able to evaluate that integral. The sorts of things we can calculate the arc length of are pretty special sorts of things.